come along and support me. Yeah, I would have been here a bit earlier, but one of my wipers gave up on the mini, and I had to turn around and go home and fix it with a bit of wire and duct tape. Yeah. Yeah. But anyway, this is a song I wrote many, many years ago. Must be 30 years ago, because it's right. Yeah, it would have been. In the days when I was shearing, sort of running in a shearing gangs around the place, and you'd be getting up early in the morning and picking up staff in Porirua and driving out the wool shed somewhere by 7 o'clock, you know. This one's called Musical Shears, for reasons which will become obvious. And I believe, I remember when they filmed me on Country Calendar, and I was going to do this song, and we had to wait for several hours for the rain to stop on the roof so we could get it filmed. Well, I wake at 5 each morning to my radio alarm, listen to the music that they play. And as the day is dawning, I head out to a farm, to another wool shed for the day. At the hour of 7, the first piece hits the floor, to the rhythm of the radio. This has been my life for 50 years or so. People ask me when I'm going slow. Well, the good Lord gives me power and woolies come my way. I've got to say I really do not know. September song, back in the 60s, before Whitby was built, the development company bought all the farms on the south side of the Papunui Inlet, and they leased them out to a chap I went to school with, actually, Glenn Hitch, and he used to employ me to, I used to ride out my back gate at Parramatta there on the horse Tosca, and Edril Amming beat a 9,000 ewes. So this is a little song about those days, riding along and listening to the birds in the springtime, riding past Duck Creek and going through the sheep and so on. So.
Song.
The sun warms the breeze as it rustles the leaves. Springtime is here and the winter is gone. Reflections gleam as I ride by the stream. It's rippling waters make music, it seems, as it flows on its way, winding down to the bay, to continue the cycle of nature's great scheme. So I ride through the sheep, lambs frolic and leap, their long tails wriggling as they drink from the teat. Then with reins in my hand, for a moment I'll stand. Give thanks to the Lord, I was born in this land. Full verse. Riding along, my pony feels strong. Birds are singing their September song. The sun warms the breeze as it rustles the leaves. Springtime is here and the winter is gone.
Fellow the Winks Jones. That looks like Winks Jones. Not Winks Jones. No, this is Ray Jones. Ray Jones. We'll do one Winks' song afterwards, but this is Winks' brother Ray. Ray used to get the sheep in for us at Eric Burden's down the coast road at Wainui and also over at Golan's Valley. And he was a guy that never married, and he used to get up sometimes at 3:30 in the morning to saddle up his horse and get everything ready and ride out through the Wainui River over the hill to Golan's Valley and get Fred Turvey out of bed to get mustering at daylight, you know. So this is the Ballad of Ray Jones. Listen to my story about this man Ray Jones. He never did get married, no, he lived all alone. But early every morning, before the sun did shine, he'd saddle up the stock horse and get his dogs in line. And in the pre-dawn darkness, he'd set out on the trail, splash across the river, through the misty veil. When the daylight came at last, he'd be high up on the hill, sending boys on their way with a whistle loud and shrill. For 60 years he's roamed these hills, and he knows what to do. From Wainui to Wurrungurrung and Golan's Valley too, he's seen a lot of changes. People come and go since his father plowed with the horses in the valley far below. The shared during smoke. Oh, his stories from our raid about the giant boar his dogs had found, or the deer he had seen that day. All those dangerous wild scruffles that lived down near the lake, as we downed our tea and coffee and scoffed another cave. Now if you're from the city, you'll find it hard to understand. And it rises at 3:30, ends in bed by 10:30. Contentment to define, I'd say Ray Jones on the hilltop before the sun begins to shine. quickly speeds from sight. Jones pictures in his memory gleam of the days of sail and the days of steam. But speed is over on our lives as the horse gives way to four-wheel drives. They trudge on to rusted bones, the horse, the dogs, and the man Wings Jones. I'm a woolly, woolly sheep, and I like to bleat. Ba, 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 and it's summertime, and I'm feeling the heat. Ba, 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 the 50 kgs of wool and mountain swing fall apart, and the shears start cutting, I'm a cootie-cootie sheep. Ba, ba, ba.
I'm a big, woolly sheep, and the smell real neat. Ba, ba, ba. Think it does use a treat. Ba, ba, ba. Big woolly sheep and the smell real neat. Ba, ba, ba.
In the month of March I did my thing. Now there's lots of lambs coming in the spring. I'd like to stand on my two back feet going ba, ba, ba. Well, I'm thirsty here and I like to drink in the ba, ba, ba. Listening to me mates all going ba, ba, ba. They brag about those tallies, sure, next thing you know, well, it's early morning.
Stuff in the mini, wouldn't
no, you?
Dear, you could have dagged him before you came. Could have dagged him in there, didn't
he? Yeah, well, anyway. Well, if I had button eyes and a head, thank you.
to be a fairly keen worker, very fast, you know. I saw him one day, he snuck up behind a Sioux and he tapped her on the shoulder and she turned around and said, "You were?" He said, "I was." Anyway.
Baggy bum bum Daggy bum, make me black and blue. Now, Frank James, Toe James, Toe James, too. I know a Jane that'll make you blue. Try to daggy bums when you're through. You'll have to thank Terry Jane all over you. Yes, the daggy bum bum. Daggy bums, they make me black and blue. That was 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 4, 5 day, 6 day, all over the floor.
600 withers, I think, up at where Belmont Regional Park is there, and I think there's a flash field shed there now. The two girls that were sweeping up were Ray Baker's daughter, and she just lived opposite the entrance to Rimutaka Forest Park, and then the weatherman, or he worked in the weather forecast, her father, and she's a Dutch girl. And she lived across the road from Asher and Baker here. And anyway, while these girls were sweeping up, Sharon started singing 1 dag, 2 dag, 3 dag, 4, and I took that line home and came back with the daggy bum boogie next time. And Alan Mugridge got hold of it, and Gumbo Tango have been making it work for them very well. Uncle, this is where I got my taste for farming. I used to go up my school holidays and to Uncle Mervyn's farm at Pycock. He farmed 2,000 acres there, and his house was just north of where Mackay's Crossing where the transmission gully is just starting to leave the main highway. Yeah, this is the last house on the right there before you get to Mackay's Crossing. And a lot of changes there now, believe you me. But where the road is now, we used to make hay over there with a horse-drawn mower and horse-drawn rake and load it into the dray and forks and trundle over to the barn, hay ride across the road to the barn and pitch it out into the barn, you know. And those were the days. Everything was done with the Clydesdales, and didn't have tractors. He had an Austin 7, and Uncle Ken had a Morris 8, I think. So it's a little, and I've got an old grey in my garden, at the top of my garden, and it sort of reminds me of those days. The wagon in my garden's resting calm, but its aging timbers hold a certain charm, reminding me of childhood days, and they still youth, toss and grace, helping Uncle Mervyn on the farm. I remember those early mornings clear, dressing Clydesdales and things they used to wear, the collars and the hanes, the blinkers and the chains, as they backed into the showers with every care. The sledging of the fence close to the line, past that old frog pond where frogs croaked all the time. With a fork we'd turn that hay and put it in the dray, and then hayride to the barn at evening time. We learned to ride on a little brown pony, who loved to run beneath a certain tree. We'd duck and take our chances on swinging those branches, I know because it happened once to me. And I remember my first ride on Uncle's roan. Things went well till we turned for home. How that horse did scarper was by the Macrocarpa. The ground came up and I was all alone. Now Uncle Mervyn's horses long have gone, where the hooves once trod tractors carry on. But in that old dray I gaze, I still think of the days of helping Uncle Mervyn on the farm. Uncle Mervyn was dying in Kenepuru, I went in with the auto harp and played that song to him. It was probably the last, I think I was his last visitor, because he died shortly after. He said, as I was leaving, he says, "Get the nurse, Derek, get the nurse." So he passed away that night.
Oh, a few years ago, I was changing a wheel on the Mini. I think it's that Mini out there, actually. And the phone went, and I had to go and shear some sheep at Akatara over there, just up past the cemetery. And sort of had to go down a left-hand drive past the cemetery. I think there's some rabbits sitting on the gatepost, some of you may know. I was going down the steep drive, and all of a sudden I heard a bit of a rumble behind me, and I'd forgotten to tighten the wheel up, hadn't I? it's a little song about that, yeah. Yeah. I pinched the tune off, who was it?
Ken Rogers.
Yeah. It happened on Sunday, that's the day before Monday. I was driving to shear a few sheep. They were down near the river where the eels do slither, and the water has lost all its heat. On finally arriving down the drive I was driving, I heard a strange sound at my rear. A bit of a rumble, a bit like a drum roll, whatever it was not clear. Thought perhaps it's a blowout, so proceeded to go out behind the car. What did I see? One naked brake drum and the couch where it had run through the gravel following me. And I had this strange feeling
could their wheels still be wheeling? There certainly ain't nowhere in sight. Probably down to the river where those eels do slither, and the water runs by day and night. You picked a fine time to leave me loose wheel. I know this old stuff must have lost his appeal. The nuts have all gone now, the brakes, they're losing their feel. You picked a fine time to leave me loose wheel. Through the trees we start searching until we are perching on the bank overlooking a bluff. And the fence didn't stop it, it must have gone hoppet. Going from here sure looks rough. I think my pneumatic must have gone all aquatic. Probably thinks it's a duck. So it's into the river where those eels do slither. We'll see if we have any luck. These rocks are so slimy, I'm thinking corblimey. These gumboots, they're useless in here. And my trousers are rolled up, it's quite wet and cold up somewhere, I think you know where. The way the current is sucking, I could be in for a ducking any time now, I feel. But around the next bend my search came to an end. There between two rocks was my wheel. You picked a fine time to leave me loose wheel. I know this old stud may have lost its appeal. The bucks have all gone now and the brakes are losing their feel. You picked a fine time to leave me loose wheel. You picked a fine time to leave me loose wheel. And Saturday night we had a big bonfire, everybody gathered around singing like, way away with Billy and Pack, and rolling over the mountain track, we'll get lost, never come back in the Tararo Ranges, or no more double blinking for me, those sort of songs, you know. And they had items from each club, so one year I sort of did this little song, sort of, yeah.
Of old Mount Vic, with a local lady leading all the way.
running down the mountain when she comes. Out of moon shadow to the sun, from the mountain victorious, she's happy and glorious. Why, it's Kate McElroy, look at what she's done. In the men's race, a chap called Johnny White was feeling fit, he thought that he might fight. He got so far ahead, he left them all for dead. King of the mountain, Johnny White, they'll be running down the mountain when they come. Kate and Johnny out there some time, they've done us all so proud. Makes you wanna yell out loud, God save the Queen and the King, King of the Mountain Run. They've done us all so proud, makes you wanna yell out loud, God save the Queen and the King of the Mountain Run. Now, with all these World Cup things going on in cricket and all sorts of sports, takes me back a few years to when I used to share for Irene van Dyke. And in fact, I think we did a bit of filming at her place for my Daggy Bum Boogie video, didn't we? She briefly appears in one of the scenes there when we're putting sheep in the yard. She used to farm, just last farm on the right before you go over the Rimutuckus. But she was probably the most famous netball goalie, I think, ever. So I wrote this song for her. It's the Silver Ferns were going over to Britain for a World Cup.
Silver ferns are waving goodbye to New Zealand tonight. They're flying so high up in the sky, to a match far out of sight. When they reach their destination at the court beyond the sea, back to here in New Zealand, we could our TV sing, have a good night, Irene. Irene, have a good night. You're standing tall to catch that ball. Irene, good night. You make a fight to shake it. She's on a roll to shoot those balls whenever she gets the ball. Those gals in green and yellow, we know they're hard to beat. But with Irene upon the scene, that need not mean defeat. Singing, have a good night, Irene. Irene, have a good night. You're standing tall to catch that ball. Irene Van Dyke, have a good night, Irene. Irene, have a good night. You're standing tall to catch that ball. Irene Van Dyke.
This is a song I wrote for Daniel Carter in 2005 when he scored 33 points against the Lions at Westpac. Anyway, no prizes for guessing what tune I'm going to use for this. Oh, Danny Boy,
the Westpac crowds are calling from goal to goal as across the line you slide. You bring us joy as you lead those lines folding, and we're so glad to have you on our side. So come ye blacks, three cheers for Daniel Carter. Score 33, let's get that man his due. And the next time the old blacks to the harker, oh Danny boy, we hope you're there to see him through.
And there has been a request too for a song I did about when I was in hospital getting my cataracts done. Andrew said somebody has requested it, so I'll do that one. It's called The Eyes Have It. Or Had It or whatever. Now here are some verses for the doctors and nurses at the clinical services wards. And I hope not to amaze, cause I couldn't see them as well as they thought that I should. The first chap I met was as black as they get, said, "Which are you having done, Juan?" I said, "Left," and then he marked my brow with his pen, just to make sure they get the right one. Next thing he did was hold open my lid for a squirt of something that hurt. Then he made me look right into such a bright light, my vision went blank, then inert. And he gave me pyjamas that made me look like those llamas from the monastery up into bed. He said, "Dr. Poole is waiting for you in the theatre and you on the set." So they wheeled me down and the crew gathered round as the fiddle I started to blow. They said, "He don't look like August, give him a local, we don't want him missing the show." So the anaesthetist man placed a tip in my hand to stop me from jumping around. Some other guy was needling my eye, tried hard not to make any sound. Next hour or so, they all had a go. They caught it, they skewered, they stripped. Through the confusion, I kept hearing infusion, then the scissors would snip. But it all got chaotic, and this antibiotic was injected straight into my arm. Oh, no pain, no gain, goes the old saying, as I squirmed and let out a wee cry. Recovery, I lie with this patch on my eye while the night nurse is pacing the floor. Perhaps tomorrow I'll see who did this to me a bit better than I did before. Thank you, Jeffries, for you keep a country music show on a Saturday afternoon on the Access Radio. You play us all those old songs and some new ones that we don't know. Thank you, Mr. Jeffries, for you keep a country music show. You used to spend those vinyls, 33s and 45s, and wind those tapes of 78s to keep that show alive. They've got so many CDs from around the world and across the nation that line your walls and wait their calls to be.
be played on that radio station.
poor old Cyril is, this is his little monkey, Harriet, you see. He's not feeling too good. He's just had a big fussed up with a missus. She's one of those domineering types. he's always telling him what to do. He never gets a word in edgeways. Anyway, so he decided to run away and join the Dingling Brothers Circus with his little monkey, Harriet. And he can be in charge for a while then. Yeah. Put your hat on straight. Yeah, thanks. Yeah. So, of course, there's got to be a country song in this somewhere, so Cyril's just finished writing one, so he's going to sing it to you now. You ready, Cyril, eh? He kind of looks a bit like Trump with his hair. So. You ready? I'll give you an intro. I think perhaps I'll go and join the circus, 'cause you have left me feeling like a clown. Then perhaps I'll have some sense of purpose as I swing my little monkey up and down. Can't wait to hear them laughing in the big top. They see my funny nose and big red smile. Perhaps I'll forget that I was a big blob. Be the center of attention for a while. You used to be the ringmaster in my life. Crack your whip, I'll do anything. Your days of animating now are over. It's me that's got the monkey on the string. You used to pack the tunes for me to dance to. A waltz, a jig, a quick step or a reel. But now it's just me and my monkey. Your animation lost its appeal. Would I have this dance for the rest of my life? Would you be my partner every night? When we're together it feels so right. Could I have this for the rest of my life? There we are. What a way to go. Well, thanks once again for coming along, and Back to the farm now, eh?
Yeah, well, goodness me, I mean, Derek's been part of the Wellington Bluegrass Society for almost as long as the Bluegrass Society's been running. And as I say, been performing floor spots for pretty much all of those, that we've had four spots, or we've had blackboard concerts, or whatever it might be. And although this is Derek's first guest spot tonight, in lieu of that contribution to the Bluegrass Society, Derek, you are now a national treasure.